seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind.
Ryan found a cemetery he liked in nearby Cicero, and with a loan from Elton John, the Whites made the 25-mile move. Here, they were welcome. Whether it was a sympathetic community or Ryan's own will, his health steadily improved. And finally, he was ready to try a new school.
Were you nervous at all this morning?
Oh, yeah. I was terribly nervous.
What do you feel like now?
I feel really good about this school. I like it a lot.
Did you believe it at first?
Not really, you know. And when I went home that night, I couldn't believe it that they were so... I said, Mom, they were all really nice, and it was just so amazing.
Jill Stewart, a friend and neighbor, remembers Ryan's first day at school.
He came on his guard. He was apprehensive, and it used to be an awkward thing that he'd just be like, thank you for just letting me be here. And you're like, Ryan, you know, we want you here. And so I know that he didn't expect it to be like it was.
How'd you do number four?
What have they given you, these kids?
Well, you know, it's giving you the more positive attitude, of course. And, you know, just to feel like you're not fighting it alone. You've got other people fighting it with you.
Yeah, right.
What if you have a negative times negative?
Accepted at last, still Ryan chose not to spend his free time like other kids, but rather to intensify his crusade.
Because of the lack of education on AIDS, discrimination, fear, panic, and lies surrounded me. I became the target of Ryan White jokes. I was labeled a troublemaker, my mom an unfit mother, and I was not welcome anywhere.
Last summer, Ryan spoke to a convention of 10,000 teachers at the Superdome. It was, he said, a group that needed educating.
Save the children of tomorrow.
Ryan, who are you doing this for, this speaking?
Well, basically for everyone who has AIDS. You know, people just aren't listening, and we have to make them listen.
Do you think you're finally getting it across?
Yeah, I think a lot more people are not afraid of AIDS now, and they're not afraid of someone who has it. And I think they're more willing to accept people who have AIDS.
Good. That's fine. Stay right there. That's good.
After 4 years of speaking out, Ryan White had become a celebrity himself. But the fame he's received has exacted a price.
I think he's just tired of being known as the AIDS boy, really, and he's known everywhere he goes. And the signing of autographs and all that, I think that's fun at first, but I think that it gets old because then it's like, why are you signing autographs? It's because I have AIDS.
What do you think all of this being in the spotlight has done to you?
You know, it's opened up a lot of your private life, and you know, there's not a whole lot you can do without somebody wanting something to do with it.
Does it take away the kind of feeling of having a normal life that you've worked so hard to achieve?
Yeah, but, you know, someday everybody's going to listen and it's going to be over, and I feel like we've done our job.
Then you'll stop talking.
Yeah.
You must hope that soon.
Yeah.
Central Supply, please call 54-0-R.
Hi. Want to get some comics?
All the way upstairs. We'll take the elevator.
Yeah, I don't feel so good.
Next week, Ryan will make his acting debut, playing a small role in a TV movie about his life.
You want to say something else?
Why should I get one? Say, no way, what for? Why do I need one?
Ryan coached the actor who played him, working 13-hour days over his summer vacation. For Ryan, this is the culmination of everything he's worked for.
Action.
You ought to get one.
Do you ever wonder why all this happened to you?
Maybe it happened to me so it wouldn't happen to anybody else. I don't know.
Ryan, you have had extraordinary success fighting this disease. Do you think you can keep fighting it?
Well, I'm going to give it my best shot.
Ryan has come a long way from his days in Kokomo, and while he may not be winning the fight against AIDS, right now he's holding his own. With help from the drug AZT, he's survived longer than most of the country's 83,000 AIDS victims. Jeannie White is hoping her son lives long enough to see a cure, but she's also realistic.
I've had him with me 4 years now where we thought that he wasn't going to live. And I feel like we've had a miracle even with 4 years.
And so, would that be enough if that's all you had?
Well, no. Is anything ever enough?
Your candle burned out long before your legend ever did.
turn me loose from your hands. Let me fly to distant lands, over green fields, trees and mountains, flowers and forest fountains, home along the lanes of the skyway, for this dark and lonely room projects a shadow cast in gloom, and my eyes are mirrors of the world outside, thinking of the way that the wind can turn the tide, and these shadows turn from purple into gray. For just a skyline pigeon dreaming of the open, waiting for the day he can spread his wings, fly away again. Fly away, skyline pigeon, fly towards the dreams you've left so very far behind. Towards the dreams you left so very far behind. Just let me wake up in the morning to the smell of newborn hay, to laugh and cry, to live and die in the brightness of my day. I wanna hear the pealing bells of distant churches sing, but most of all, please free me from this aching metal ring, and open out this cage towards the sun. For just this skyline pigeon dreaming of the open, waiting for the day he can spread his wings and fly.